Good morning, everyone. We're continuing here in the words of the Mesillas Yesharim. The Ramchal finishes off this idea today about how careful we have to be with our money when he writes the following: Amnam klal shel davar. The main principle is kemo shechemdes hamam min rabba. Since that the desire that people have for money is so great, you see the whole world is running after money, geld, kesef, making a deal over here, make a deal over there, investments, getting this money, getting that paycheck, putting it in the bank, spending on this. The whole world is chemdas hamam, and everybody has a lust and a desire for money. Therefore, ken michshalois of rabim. So the mistakes that people can make with their money is also very great. Kadei she'adam nakimem be'emes, in order for a person to be clean from them in truth, which means that he uses and he runs his monetary dealings according to halacha, and there's not even a shem, it's not even a trace of sin that is there. Iyun gadol v'dikto grav tzarech lo'i. It requires an enormous amount of study and clarifying and diktok and being very particular in the way that he deals with his finances. V'imnika mimeno. And if a person finds that he's clean in these areas, yeda she'egiya kvar l'madrega gadol, he should know that he reached a very high level already. Ki rabim yischazdu be'anofim rabim be'anfe ha'chassidus. There are many different levels in the realms of piety. And this, that a person is clean in their money, that they're careful in particular to make sure that not even a single penny extra has gone into their hands. U'be'inyin sinas ha'betza lo'yochel regiel mechaz ha'shleimus. And if a person doesn't desire such things, then he's not going to be able to reach a shleimus. He won't be able to reach perfection. There's a famous story of the Rabbi Moshe Chaim Luzzatto that he had a Talmud who came to him one day, and he says, Rebbe, he says, I don't belong in the Beis Midrash. Learning's not for me. I'm not going to go into a life of chinuch, of teaching and continued learning anyway. I really want to go to business. Because if I go to business, I have a good business mind. I'll be a businessman. I'll make money. I'll support yeshivas. I'll support your yeshiva, Rebbe. I'll pay the bills. I'll have a nice place to live for my wife and my children. I'm going to go into business. So Rabbi Yisroel Salanter said, ooh, you're going to go into business. You should know that there's a lot of halachas, there's a lot of laws you need to know to make sure that you conduct your affairs and business according to halacha. So he says, I can't let you go out to business yet. He said, sit, learn chesh and mishpat, which are all the laws of monetary dealings. Learn it well, and when you finish learning it, you'll come to me and I'll give you a bechina, I'll test you to see how well you know it. So the boy didn't argue with his Rebbe, and he went and he sat, and for the next 2 years, plugged away over there in yeshiva, and he learned the Gemaras, and he learned the Rishonim, and he learned the Shulchan Aruch, until finally he felt that he had some expertise in the field of Chesh and Mishpat. He went to Rav Yisroel Salanter, and Rav Yisroel Salanter gave him a test. And at the end of the test, he says, ah, he says, you know the laws of Chesh and Mishpat so well, chaval, you have to go into business. He says, with a mind like that, and with the understanding of the Torah the way that you have it, he says, you'd be a great Pesach. You'd make a great leader of Klal Yisrael in the area of Psak Halach, of giving over the Halachas. But the part of the story that we're taking for ourselves is that if you want to be naki, if you want to be clean, to make sure that everything that you're doing is according to Torah law, then you have to learn appropriately. You have to know what you're learning, what you're doing, in order to keep things in the right way. And he writes, of Yehumasha, Omar Tseifan, Amasi, Le'iyav. Iyav had a friend who said to him, if you have weights in your hand, or I'm saying, if you have sin in your hand, so get rid of it, distance it. Don't keep any sin in your tents. And you'll really ruin yourself, said his friend to Iyav, and you won't fear HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So if you have any funny business going on over there with your money, you have funny business going on with your weights and your measures, he said, get it out of your tents, otherwise lo yisir, you won't fear. Meaning, divarti adheinu mipratei mitzvah achas min ha-mitzvahis. Up until this point, says the Ramchal, I've spoken about one of the numerous mitzvahs, u'kepratei chilukim, eile vandai she'imtsoim v'chol mitzvah. We spoke about all the details, all the parameters of this mitzvah, but you should know, every mitzvah in the Torah is like this. But I'm only going to mention the type of mitzvahs over here that the majority of people are nichshol, that they stumble into and they make mistakes because of, as he writes over here, chemdas hamam and rabba, the lust and the love and the desire for money is very great, and therefore it's so, the greater that is, the greater the opportunity for people to fall and to make mistakes in the monetary world as well. So we should be zeichem, yetz Hashem, to learn the halachas properly, to instill within inside of ourselves the necessary yir shemayim, and in that way we will be naki, we will be clean from any trace of improper conduct with our monetary gains. All the best.